to video lessons. I am P.T. Joseph, mathematics and science teacher working under Mysore Diocese Education Society. In the previous class, we introduced the topic chemical reactions. Due to unavoidable circumstances, we are not able to continue the same topic. Hence, today we are going to introduce a new topic. Children, we come across so many gadgets in our day-to-day life, maybe domestic or industrial. Can anyone name some of such gadgets? Yes, mixer grinder, yeah, that's fine. Then washing machine, right? Then electric fan, okay, fine. Then what? Why not your mobile phone? That is also a very good example for today's gadgets, no? Now, let me ask you a question. These gadgets and many more require an inseparable factor without which these gadgets doesn't function. Can anyone name that inseparable entity which is very, very essential for the functioning of these gadgets? Yeah, somebody there? Yes, battery. Oh, okay, okay, batteries. Do you use a battery for your ceiling fan? No, we don't use a battery. In the kitchen for the mixer grinder? No. Only for the mobile phone we use a battery, right? Okay, but I want a precise reply answer for this question. What is the crucial factor, crucial entity? Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, that is right. Great. So today we are going to learn about electricity. Children, the concept of electricity is very clear. If you go back into the history of electricity, you come across many persons and their contributions. It is believed that the ancient Greeks as well as the Persians had a knowledge of electricity. William Gilbert and Thomas Brown, two British physicists, jointly coined the word electricity. In your previous classes, you have come across charges in nature. How many types of charges are there? Yes, positive charge and negative charge. Positive and negative charge. Dear children, flow of water through a stream is called water current. Similarly, flow of air constitute air current. Similarly, flow of charges through a conductor constitute electric current. So what is electric current? Electric current is defined as the rate of flow of charges. Electric current is defined as rate of electric current is defined as rate of flow of charges. Charge by duration of flow. Children, current is given by relation charge divided by time. The symbol for current is I, charge is Q, time is T. So current is measured in terms of ampere. The unit of electric current is ampere. So here, remember the great scientist André-Marie Ampère, a French physicist who contributed his mind to the field of electricity. As a respect, the unit of current is taken as ampere. Now we are going to work out a simple problem, making all simple problem based on this relation. A current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament lamp for 10 minutes. Find the amount of electric charge that flows through the lamp. Now we are going to solve this problem. We will list the data given. Current I is equal to 0.5 ampere. Time taken T is equal to 10 minutes. We have to find the amount of charge that flows through the lamp. Q is equal to question mark. We know the relation I is equal to Q by T. From this, if you cross multiply, you get Q is equal to I into T. I is current, 0.5 ampere. Time is 10 minutes. The unit of time is seconds, so 10 minutes is converted into seconds. 10 into 60, if you simplify, 0.5 into 10 is 5, 5 into 60 is 300. 300 coulomb. Coulomb is the unit of electric charge. As a respect to the great French scientist, Charles Augustin Coulomb, the unit of electric charge is taken as Coulomb. Okay. Children, you are aware that water flows from a high-rise point to a lower point. If the level is maintained, then water may not flow through a pipe. So for the flow of water, a level difference is required. This we call as gradients. A gradient is required. A level difference is required for the flow of water through a pipe. Similarly, if charges has to flow through a metal wire, a conductor, there should be a pressure difference or charge density difference across two points in a metal wire, across two points in a metal wire. At one point, the charge density should be high, and at the other point, the density of charges should be less. Then charges flow from the point of higher density to the point of lower density in an electric field or through a conducting wire. The charge density at a point in an electric field or a conductor is called electric potential at that point. The electric potential at that point. The difference in electric potential between two points in an electric field or across two points in an electrical conductor can be referred to as potential difference. Potential difference across two points in an electric field or across two points in an electrical conductor can be defined as the work done to move a unit positive charge across these two points. The unit of potential difference is volt as a respect to the great scientist Alessandro Volta, who devised the first electric cell, the voltaic cell. The unit of potential difference is taken as volt. Potential difference is given by the relation work done by charges flow. The unit of potential difference is volt, work done is joules, charges flow is coulomb. Volt is represented by V, is equal to joules per coulomb. Per coulomb is represented as C raised to the power minus 1. So voltage is given by the relation work done per coulomb. Children, based on this relation, we will work a very simple problem. How much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across two points having a potential difference 12 volt? The problem. The data given in the question is listed here. Charge Q is equal to 2 coulombs. Potential difference V is equal to 12 volts. Work done has to be found. We know the relation. Potential difference is equal to work done by charges flow. V is equal to W by Q. If you cross multiply, you get W is equal to V into Q. Potential difference is 12 volts and charges is 2 coulombs. You multiply, you get 24. Work, the unit of work done is joules. So 24 joules is the work done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across two points maintained at 12 volts potential difference. Now we are going to demonstrate a very simple experiment on electricity. I have connected a battery to an LED bulb, from there to an ammeter, from the ammeter to a switch and back to the battery. All the components, the battery, the LED bulb, the ammeter and the switch, all are in series connection. If I switch on this circuit here, but this closed path for the flow of charges through various components is called an electric circuit. If I switch on this circuit, charges, that is electrons, flow to the switch, from there to the ammeter, from the ammeter to the LED bulb and back to the battery. So negative, from the negative terminal of the battery, the charges, the electrons flow through the switch to the ammeter, from the ammeter to the LED bulb and back to the battery. A conventional current is assumed to flow in the opposite direction, that is from the positive terminal to the LED bulb, from there to the ammeter, from the ammeter to the switch and back to the battery, hence completing the circuit. When a conventional current flows through the LED bulb, you can see it lights up. If I switch off this circuit, the current flowing through the LED bulb is cut off and the LED goes off. The electric circuit used in the demonstration is represented diagrammatically as follows. The battery is represented by this symbol. You can see the direction of flow of conventional current from the battery to the lamp LED bulb, from the lamp to the ammeter. Ammeter shows the amount of current flowing through the circuit when the circuit is switched on. From the ammeter to the switch, it is in on position. From the switch back to the battery, hence the circuit is completed. So this is a simple electric circuit. Wherein you have a battery, you have a board or a lamp, you have an ammeter, switch. Everything connected in series. So this is a simple representation of an electric circuit. The various symbols used in an electric circuit, I'm not showing all the symbols, only some of the symbols used in an electric circuit. This is an electric cell. This symbol is used, positive, negative, and see two parallels, one is little longer than the other. This is a combination of cells. 1, 2, 3 cells are combined and it is called a battery. A combination of cells is a battery. This is a lamp. A lamp in a circuit is represented this way. An open switch is represented this way. This is a closed switch and this is an open switch, and an ammeter is represented this way. This is the positive terminal of the ammeter, this is the negative terminal of the ammeter. Whenever you see such a symbol, it represents an ammeter. If switch is like this, it is open. If it is like this, it is closed. And if you see a symbol like this, that is a lamp, electric lamp or a load. This is a battery and this is a single cell. Children, in today's class, we learned about the history of electricity. We learned about electric current. Electric potential and potential difference. We have learned how to work out simple problems in electricity. We also demonstrated a simple experiment and we learned how to draw the circuit diagram of a simple electric experiment. Children, you have a home assignment. I have given you 4 simple questions. Answer this at home. First one, what is electric current? Second one, define potential difference. Third one, draw a simple electric circuit and label the components. Fourth one, it's a problem. An electric heater draws a current of 4 ampere from the 220 volt mains for 10 minutes. Calculate the amount of charge that flow through the heater. Children, for now, wish you all the best. Thank you.